Hello everybody, and welcome back to another video of Weird Pirate Games, but it's number 3. Today I'm going to be playing Tian Da Sheng, which is basically another journey to the West RPG. And also, Bruce, that kind of looks like you. Yeah, this is the only Bruce joke I'm going to make. Now, what is this guy? You can also Google Translate if you want, like I said in the previous two videos, but they may come out as wrong. Random people. Yep, more Chinese nonsense.
I can understand Chinese.
At least the music is somewhat not annoying. And also, this is NJ082, meaning that's right, the cart name. The previous ones were 35, or 36, or N63. Actually, it was 38 and 63. But yeah. So, apparently I can't find any more Shenzhen Nanjing ROMs, or after at least one other Shenzhen Nanjing game, it's going to be more Shenzhen Dakota. Because really, that's the only available ROMs that there is up there. Chinese. Talking to every NPC. Don't worry, the music will change soon. And you can't go down here. Can we get infinite money from here? No. End. So, like I said before, this was based off Journey to the West, which is a very famous Chinese book. And so many players like it for no reason. Oh great, here comes some random encounters. Oh my.
Yep.
Just going over to the next door village. Actually, there's not that much game footage, just online. So yeah, really this would be the first time I ever showed off the full gameplay of this, or more like a 20-minute version of the gameplay. Hmm. Nice. So yeah, there's not that. This is really gonna be the first video showing off at least a couple of gameplay elements of this game because, let me tell you, there's not that much of it online for some odd reason. And why I'm showing it out to you personally, eh? I know you don't get my joke. Man, these enemies do take a while to just do it. There you go. I wonder if they have arrows for healing. Aren't they supposed to kill you? Well, unless you're talking about Minecraft, where apparently healing...
Apparently there's such thing as, like, dipping healing arrows.
Man, this enemy will not seriously die. Guess it's time to use another one.
Just readjusting my position. Excuse me. These enemies do take a while just to kill.
That was the last shot. I hope I got an upgrade. Yes, I did. Save. Oh, look at that. They tried to recreate an enemy from Chrono Trigger, and yet what happened? It apparently didn't go so well. So, that's what you get what happens when you try to recreate something from your previous games. And, yes, For the other ones, I did give Chrono Trigger from 2003, but that was just my estimation. The official year is unknown, so I'm just gonna give this one a, let's say 2007. Oh, great, so now we're finding stuff from Chrono Trigger. Yeah, who said so? So yeah, this is basically just gonna be me just going through random different types of battles.
Also, the entire overworld is just a pathway for no reason.
And yes, you already may have noticed, the characters walk too fast. So yeah, after I at least do another Shinjin Nanjing game, and after that I'm just gonna do Shinjin Dakota games, which is also from the Shinjin region of China. A little bit of geography there, but okay. Especially if you're in summer school, but I don't think you are. Also, it seems like
you people don't like the Chrono Trigger one a lot.
Maybe that's because that you don't like Chrono Trigger altogether. But I bet you don't know what Journey to the West is unless you're Chinese and you somehow managed to know it. But hey, it's not my fault that they created the book, and it's not even my fault that they created this.
It's already in the public domain like many years ago.
And of course, China don't have no copyright law. But that's not my problem. Okay, that's about it, and now let's go into the village. It's just readjusting. Okay, so I know what to do next. Despite the fact that I was in completely random Chinese, let's go to the inn first. Yes, I do. They no longer even say have a good day. That was easy. Let's defeat this one. Two things about bosses. They're horrible, and they're like losers. Whoa. Okay, killed off the first one. Oh, I hope I don't die. Yeah, I died. Don't worry, let's do it again.
Yeah, deserted village.
Random Chinese guy, you can pause the video if you want to do Google Translate, but I'm just gonna be going to save
that every single weird parody video.
And yes, and if you're wondering, as for the Neverhood series, well, I kinda already done with it. I really wanna focus this over to summer, so yeah. So, I'll no longer be making a new Neverhood videos. Unless it's like the Sega Genesis version of Neverhood. That I will eventually upload someday. First of all, I need some strength training. And this is the best place to go. This is the great place. There we go, there are some hard enemies that we can defeat. I died again. Oops, I accidentally started a new game. There we go. Oh, nice, I'm finding Chrono Trigger stuff now. How convenient. It's not. Oh yeah, we're doing this cutscene again. I'll just leave you off with some music. The town and the any shop. And now for battles. Guys, that was about it. The next one will be a backport of, I'm gonna pronounce this incorrectly, I think that's how you pronounce it. It's an anime series, and yeah. So that was about it, and I will see you in the next Werid pirating game, which is gonna be number 4. Bye!